Hey everyone, I'm Samyak Agarkar and welcome to Agarkar Media Academy. This is the 10th tutorial in Blender Animation Tutorial Series. In the last tutorial, we saw how to create this awesome scene and we rendered it out in rendered mode. From here, we just put render image and this is what we created in the last tutorial, right? So what we are going to do in this tutorial is we are just going to give colors to all these objects. So first let's go to the solid shading mode Z, and then I'm just moving my mouse to go to the solid shading mode. So let's change colors. Now to change colors, we cannot do it just here. There is a way to do it here also, but Blender has already organized these many workspaces which are very easy to use and have all the panels opened up ready made. So we are just going to go to the shading panel. Coloring is all about shading. So let's go to the shading panel. This is our viewport. Here you can see we are in the material preview mode so that we can see what is going on in the material preview mode. If we are in the solid mode and if we give some shading to this object, we won't be able to see it just right here because we are not viewing the materials. To view materials, we have to always go to the material preview mode or rendered mode if the light or the lamps is rightly placed and rightly configured. So let's move to the material preview mode. I am first of all selecting the ground, I am selecting the plane, right? Now we just need to create a new material. This is where a new material can be created. If you just look at here, here we can have all these tabs open, all these editor types open, but right now we are in the shader editor panel, shader editor type panel. So we just need to create a new material. Once we have selected the plane, create new. And we have this node. So shading in Blender comes from nodes. So these are nodes that we need to edit to shade or to change the textures of the object. So right now this is, let me just grab it upwards so that we can see what's going on. So this is our principled BSDF shaded. This has been changed in the last two or three versions of Blender. Before that, creating new material would give you a diffuse texture, but now diffuse is not there, we just have a principled BSDF. Don't need to get into the details, we'll be looking at the details soon in the next few tutorials. For now, we just need to change the base color. So base color is all about the color. So if we just change the base color, why is it not showing up? Base color, yeah. So we just need to change the base color. As you can see, as I'm dragging the pointer on the color wheel, I can see the color being changed on the ground also, on the viewport also. Let's make it dark brown. So I'm taking, light red and just moving up the brightness, moving down the brightness so that it looks brown. So this is our brown plane. Let's just color the sphere. I'm just selecting the sphere, create new. Also one thing to note here, we can change the name of the material. So here you can see, if I just drop down this, all those materials which we have created till now will be stored. Material is the default material that we get. Material 001 is what we created for the ground. You can see the brown color right here. Material 002 is this one. We can change the name of the material. Let's say sphere, let's say red, because we are going to make it red. So now you can see the red color is there. If I go to the materials panel and I change the color, the name to brown, then, you know, naming these textures is really, really important, because then, organizing the textures and organizing the materials become very easy. So let's just change the base color to red. This is our red color. Let's just create a new material for torus. Let's make it green. And change the base color to green, light green. Then let's cone, color the cone. We are going to give it a yellow color and change the base color to yellow, something like this. And for the cylinder, we are going to go for let's say blue. And blue. Cool. So it looks awesome. We have already colored all of them. All these materials are now saved here. So if you add a new material here, let's go to layout panel. Here you cannot see the colors just yet, because always remember, by default we are in the solid mode. We just need to change it to either material preview or rendered mode, right? So many a times it happens that you give colors to all of these materials, all of these objects in shading panel, and then when you go to layout, you don't see colors and you're like, what happened, right? So you don't need to worry, just check that you are not in the solid or wireframe mode. Wireframe mode is very easily visible because it's wire everywhere. Solid mode and material preview and rendered mode are a little bit difficult to observe. You just need to know what is happening there. So when you are in solid mode, you cannot see the colors. If you are in rendered material preview mode, then you can see the flat colors, right? There is no shading happening. There is no shadows happening right here. You can see that the shadows should have been visible right here because we have the lamp here, but no shadows can be seen because material preview does not take into consideration the lights that you have in the scene. They just understand all the materials that are being used. So light does not have a material. That's why they don't consider the materials, the lights. They just consider the materials that are being used. So let's go to the rendered mode. Here you can see it's being colored, right? So in the layout panel, just press 0 to go to the panel where camera will be there. So this is the camera view. Now here you can see that the brightness is too low. The ground is not exactly visible. So we are just going to change the brightness of the lamp. So just select the lamp right here. You can select the lamp right here. From here, let me just move myself away. Just a sec. Yeah. So we have selected the lamp. Where is the lamp? This is the lamp, or you can select it from light here. Let's go to the light object data properties. It gives a lamp like structure, right? So this is our light. So just go to light, and here you can see all the options for light. So this is a point light. As you can see, the point light is basically giving out colors, just giving out light just from one single point. If you make it sun, then it will be a directional light which is illuminating everywhere. So we don't want a sun just right now, or maybe we want a sun just right now. A spot lamp is basically a focus lamp, right? You can see the cone right here, and this cone is only colored, right? The light is passing only through those cones, right? So this is about the spotlight. It basically gives a spot lamp. And the area light. Area light is basically one pane is there which is illuminating light in one single direction. So let's use point sun lamp. For the sun lamp, we want the color to be yellowish, because again the sun is a bit yellowish, not too yellow like this, just a little bit of yellow color there. And the strength is too high. You can see everything is being blown out, nothing is visible, no colors are exactly visible, and it looks like the light is too harsh, right? So we just need to decrease the strength from here. This is by experience. I know that the strength of 5 for sun looks great, right? You can just increase the strength, or you can just slide out the strength right here to see what looks best for you. I think 5-6 would look great. This one is looking great. Let's go to the 0. Here is what you can see, all these colors as well as the shadows being happening. And now let's just render image, render and render image. And this is what you have. So as you can see right now, it took 1.66 seconds. So it's almost same, because we don't have too many things to work around with. We don't have very complicated textures and objects to work with. So the rendering is very, very fast here. So let's just save this image, save, and we are going to save it in the same panel, tutorial 10, right? And just save image, and let's go to the panel right here, G, My Projects, Blender Renders, and this is one that we have created. looks really, really awesome. Let me just move myself out of the window. Good. So this is what we did before, and this is what we have done it now. Before, now, before, now. What I feel is the lamp is being moved a little bit, so the coloring, we did not use the lamp here, we used sun, and the direction of the sun lamp was different, so the shadows are completely different. But if we use the same lamp and we colored things differently, colored the things in the same way, then the shadows would have been the same. Just because we changed the lamp type from point to sun, because of that, the angle of light was also changed, and the intensity of light was also changed. So you can see the difference in shadows. But otherwise, it looks really, really awesome. So this is it for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't yet subscribed to this YouTube channel, please do subscribe. Share this video with your friends and family so that they can also learn this awesome tool, Blender 3D animation software, and they can also create some awesome stuff. If you create some good stuff, good animations using Blender, please put it on Instagram and tag me. My username is Samyak Agarkar, SamyakAgarkar. Tag me on Instagram if you create some good renders, and let's see what awesome things that you can create from Blender. So that is it for this video. In the next video, we will learn something new. And till then, keep smiling and keep learning.